arrhythmias, guys. I am excited. We are almost there. There are 5 parts to this series, so we are on part 3 today. 2 more to go.
So, in part 3 today, we are touching on PACs and PVCs. Premature atrial or ventricular contraction. What the heck does that mean? Well, good thing you asked, because that's what I'm teaching you about today. We are going to go over the causes, the management, the symptoms, and what else is there? What it is. Let's go over PACs first. So premature atrial contractions. So those are also supraventricular. So PACs are really just beats that happen too early. That's all it is. Now these beats can happen isolated, so by themselves, or they can happen more frequently in your cardiac rhythm. So non-conductive PACs have a P wave, but then there's no QRS complex after it. So look below at the EKG strip. That is a PAC. Remember, this is happening in the atrium. This is not happening in the ventricles. We are talking about PACs. So what in the world even causes this? Well, you could overdose a patient on digoxin and you could cause PACs. It's caused by cardiac conditions, more serious cardiac conditions, or it can even be caused by COPD. And symptoms-wise, normally you don't even know this is happening. You could be walking around and having PACs all the time. And management-wise, there's really nothing to do. Sometimes these resolve on their own, but the fact that you might not even know you're having them, what is there to manage? Now that we're done with PACs, let's move over to PVCs. So PVCs are extra heartbeats that happen in your lower chambers, which are your ventricles. Now there are 4 types of PVCs that I learned about in nursing school, so I'm going to read off of my notes that I took about PVCs. So the first type of PVC that I learned about was a unifocal, so monomorphic PVC. It's the same morphology in the same lead throughout the entire rhythm strip. The PVCs came from the exact same location. Now, let's move on to multifocal. So multiform polymorphic, also another name for it. So the PVCs originated in different locations and they are different sizes and different shapes. The third type of PVC that I learned about was interpolated. So this does not interfere with the normal cardiac cycle. It occurs between 2 regular beats. And then there is R on T, you will hear it called, which is a premature beat occurring on the T wave during repolarization. This beat occurs so early that the cells are still in the relative refractory period. And this produces a weak ventricular contraction, which leads to VTAC or VFib. So R on T is the worst type of PVC that you can have. So take a look at the tele strips and see the difference between the 4 different types of PVCs that I just talked about. Now let's go into causes of PVCs. So what is causing all those types of PVCs? Well, caffeine, tobacco, heart failure, electrolyte imbalances, exercise and stress can even cause PVCs. What symptoms could a person even have? You could be totally asymptomatic and having PVCs. Or you could be short of breath, you could be weak, you could even be lightheaded or have hypotension. So management-wise, what are you going to do for PVCs in your patients? You need to treat the underlying cause. Is it an electrolyte imbalance? Well then, replete those electrolytes. Let's get this person back to homeostasis. Increase oxygen in their body if they weren't getting enough oxygen during exercise. You really just need to treat the underlying cause of this PVC. And guys, that does it for the 3rd part of this series for cardiac dysrhythmias. So guys, Thursday I will be posting about heart blocks and all the kinds of heart blocks and what to do. So make sure to stay tuned for that. Make sure to subscribe and hit that little alert notification bell so you know when I have videos posted. Have a blessed day, everybody, and I will see you in Thursday's video.